This video presents the section and elevation range feature. This enables you to define the range of the marker directly from the section and elevation window. Let's open a section placed on the floor plan. A gray fill represents the area of the model outside of the section range. The linear border, surrounded by the marker's end nodes, have an enhanced visualization. If you click on the horizontal boundary, you can freely replace it on both sides. When moving it, the tracker displays the boundary distance from the original point. This change will occur on the marker placed on the floor plan as well. In the top of the section window, you can find various marks. These show the location of the boundary and break lines. Hover over any marks or edges. A full-height, bold, solid line appears vertically, and a tooltip displays the name of the corresponding lines. A black dash indicates the horizontal boundaries on the sides and on the section line break. The dark gray dash displays the marked distant break. And the medium gray dash represents the depth break. Let's drag them and check the results in the section window and on the floor plan. To remove a break, drag the break line outside of the horizontal range. This will also delete the break from the section marker as well. Let's right-click in the section window and open the section settings from the context menu. Choose the limited vertical range option. As you can see, vertical boundaries also appear on the screen and enable you to graphically edit the upper and lower limits. Please note that in the interior elevation window, only the vertical range can be edited. You can turn on or off the range feedback from the context menu, or by using the Design, Section Elevation Range menu command. The Edit Range or Limit Lines graphically helps when you're working on section and elevation windows, as there's no need to always go back to set these on the floor plan.